Join me as we create this slashed text logo using our beloved Canva. We're going to jump in on Photopea and convert it into a 3D. From your Canva homepage, create a brand new blank logo canvas in order to start your design. Once you're done, you're going to then add text. You want to press T to add text, or you could use the text on the left hand side. Then you're going to change your text to archival black, and then you're going to use your text that you would like to create. So we can use RM as an example. Then you're going to increase the size of your logo to maybe 170. You can make it a little bit bigger if you want. And once that's done, you're going to go to your elements and you're going to search for line. So you can type line and then you can search for a graphic line that is going to slash through your text. So I found this line that I used, and then you make it big and you twist it to an angle, and then you move it over to your text ever so slightly so that it slashes through the R and the M at the corner. I'm gonna flip it, I'm gonna flip it vertically, and then I'm gonna move it so that it slashes through. Like that. Once you've created your slashed line through your text, you're then going to add this rectangle. So you can press R for rectangle or just click once to have that. We're going to change color so that we see what we're doing. And then you can size it and make it nice and big. And then you're going to tilt it to the side so that it runs through that line of ours. So you're going to move it ever so gently so that it goes through the line that you are trying to design. You can make it fill up the rest of the page, and then you're going to copy this either by copy or Control C or Command C if you're using a Mac, and then you're going to Control V or Command V if you're using a Mac, and then you're going to move the second copy to the bottom of the page, and then you're going to click on it and move it ever so gently so that it is exactly on the line like that, so that we don't see anything. Then we know that they are aligned like that. Perfect. Once you've done that first part, you're going to duplicate this page so that you have an exact same page on the following page. Then you're going to click on the top rectangle, delete that, and then click on the bottom rectangle, change color to white. And you have your top slash. Go to the second page, click on the bottom of your rectangle, delete that, click on the top rectangle, change color to white. Then you have your slash for page one and page two. Now, you would like to convert this into an image. Then you're going to go File, and you're going to download the pages. If you have the transparent background and you're using Pro, download it as a transparent, and then you download your page one, and you do exactly the same for page two. Once you've downloaded that, you're going to click and add a brand new page. Then you're going to drag your logo that you've just downloaded as an image, the page one, and then you're going to crop it. And once you've cropped it, then you will move it to the top and then size it. Make it 400. And you drag the second page as well. So what you can do then is you go to edit and you remove the background and you apply, and the background is removed. Then we crop it, then we size it to 400. so that it's exact size as the top section. Now I have my two designs. Now I need to change color to any color that I would like to have these images be. So you're going to click on the image, and then you're going to go to duotone, and I'm going to change it to whichever color that I would like to have this be. Now I'm going to combine them nicely aligned. Can you bring the two images together like that, so that it's slashed? Next, you're going to add a rectangle so that, and we want to pick the color that it looks exactly like our duotone color that we added. Lastly, you're going to add your text, and you're going to make that color red as well. Group it, and your logo, the 2D logo, is done. You can group it and then make it a little bit big if you want. Then it moves all of the layers at the same time. And you're done with your 2D logo. You would then go File or Share and click on Download. Download it as a transparent background. And we want page number 3. We're going to go and download that. Once your logo is downloaded, you're going to go to Photopea. And on Photopea, we're going to use the templates that are already there, but you can upload your own. You're welcome to look at any of the videos that I've created to help you use your own PSD mockups. I'm going to use this gorgeous PSD mockup created by the graphics family. You just click on the mockup itself, and then you click on the photopea.com link. It would then load the mockup for you. Once the mockup is loaded, you're going to go to where it says your logo here. You double click, and then the text is still displaying. You just click on the eye to hide the text. You click and you drag the 2D logo we just created, and then you size it to whatever size you like. So that particular mockup makes the logo smaller. That's why I've made it a little bit bigger, so that when we are converting it and it is on the actual mockup, it looks bigger than it is. Then you're going to go File, Save as Smart Object, and it will convert to Smart Objects. Then you click once where it says Logo Mockup, and then you slashed gorgeous looking 3D logo is created. When you are happy and you would like to download the 3D logo and share it with your customer, you're going to go File, Export As. I'm going to use PNG. There's other options that are available. You click on PNG, and then you can name your logo over there, and then you click on Save. And your 3D logo is created, slashed looking, amazing, different kind of a vibe when it comes to logo. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please click on the like button so that YouTube can share it with lots of people. You can watch the next logo video that talks about shapes that you could use on Canva to create amazing looking logos. Thank you for your time. I do appreciate it. I will see you next time.